The Beatles prove they're still here, there, and everywhere. That's after the band's recent single, Now and Then, topped the UK music charts 60 years after their first number one hit, From Me to You. This makes them the act with the longest gap between their first and last number ones. Billed as the last Beatles song, Now and Then features the voice of the late member John Lennon and was developed with a little help from artificial intelligence. It also features parts recorded by surviving members Paul McCartney and Ringo Starr, as well as the late George Harrison. The SAG-AFTRA Actors Union celebrating its strike, ending breakthrough with Hollywood studios by vowing to help other unions in negotiating their upcoming contracts. Earlier this week, the Actors Union has reached a tentative agreement with studios, effectively ending their strike. This development allows Hollywood to ramp up to full production for the first time since May, once union members vote to ratify the deal. So far, 86% of SAG-AFTRA's board support the deal.
Among the gains members will enjoy in this new contract cycle are, one, more than $1 billion in new wages and benefit plan funding. A streaming participation bonus for performers who work on shows in streaming that become successful. Minimum compensation increases that break the so-called industry pattern and help our members keep up with the harm that's been caused by inflation. And so in 2024, when IATSE, the AFM, and the Teamsters enter their negotiations, SAG-AFTRA members look forward to rallying behind their fight for their own fair contracts.
Members of the Actors Union staged a massive job walkout in July, demanding higher pay and protection from AI innovations. It followed the strike by the Writers Union, which has since reached a deal with studios. A woman obsessed with game shows reunites with her older sister to repay their mother's gambling debts in the newest comedy, Quiz Lady. Our Hollywood correspondent, Yong Chavez, talks to its director, Jessica Yu, about her experience working with a film star-studded cast.
What is the square root of 196?
14.
Correct. How many hearts?
In the comedy Quiz Lady, Sandra Oh and Awkwafina team up for the first time as sisters who grew up in a dysfunctional family who must work together to save a loved one. In interviews completed before the actors' strike, the stars talked about their characters and their experiences in making the film.
Racist! Oh. Hi.
We have this classic odd couple sibling-ness, right? Ooh, one's wild, one's very stable, one's right and one's wrong. As you come to it, it kind of gets mixed up. And you can't say that this person's just a flake or that person's not showing up. I really feel like the piece is also is very much about both of their awakenings, but Anne's awakening to that there's a whole set of stories and beliefs that she's thought about her sister that she was wrong about.
The movie is directed by Jessica Yu, and in the pre-taped interview, Awkwafina shares how the director encouraged the actors to improv.
Working with Jessica, it's such an incredibly insane energy of like warmth, of acceptance, of like curiosity, of just kind of like the ability to listen to everyone. And so there was already such a crazy, warm, secure, safe environment that I felt like there was no way to not do it than improv. And I'm such a huge fan of Sandra. She's one of my in my opinion, one of the best comedic actresses.
Quiz Lady also stars Will Ferrell and Jason Schwartzman.
In the past, in movies that dealt with our Asian cultures and family stories, you can sometimes feel how the filmmakers grappled with the weight and responsibility of a representation, and you could feel how they also worried about how we will be viewed by audiences. But in this film, you can see how, you know, the confidence in your storytelling and your confidence in the material.
Our characters need to be true to themselves and to the story, and like in the case of Jenny, Sandra Oh's character, she can be inappropriate, she can be very self-serving. These weren't roles where we had to say, oh, let's explain who they are, let's explain their experience. It was like, no, this is their story. We're going to follow and see what works out for them, and we'll understand things just as we need them. So that feels to me a little bit different than some roles in the past for Asian American characters.
Quiz Lady can be seen on Hulu in the U.S. and in Disney Plus in other countries. Yong Chavez, ABS-CBN News, here in Hollywood.